are you? I hope you are doing well. Okay, so I'd like to ask you one question before starting the class. Do you remember that what we have done in our previous class? Yes, we have learned about making requests and responding them. Now, just imagine that it's about to rain and you can see the cloudy day and you want to switch on the light inside the classroom and you are making request to switch on the light to me. So how will you make request? Yes, you are right. Would you mind switching on the light, ma'am? Yes, or could you please switch on the light, ma'am? Yes, in that way we can make request. Okay, so now let's begin today's class. You can see animals there, right? Very dangerous animals in the slide. What are they? Do you have any idea? Have you ever heard about them? Okay, yes, they are beasts. You know, beasts are the animals, especially large and dangerous four-footed ones. Okay, they have four foot and they're very dangerous and they're large and strong. Okay, so have you ever been scared thinking of them or hearing about them? We can hear their stories, especially, right? So have you ever been scared? Okay, maybe you have been scared, right? When we will hear about them or think about them at night, then we will get scared. Do you think we can be together with them? Do you think that? In our real life, do you think that we can be together, we can have our lunch or dinner together, or we can play or dance together? Do you think so? Of course not. In maybe just like in imaginary life, then there maybe we can guess or we can think about them, we can imagine about them, but in our real life, it may not be. Just look at here, like this way, having some lunch or dinner together. Yeah, or just like this, dancing together with them. Oh my God, no, right? We get scared, we can't do so. So now, can you guess what we are reading today? What we are discussing about today? Yes, you are right. We are discussing about beast today. Okay, we are reading a very interesting story. Okay, I hope you will enjoy reading it. Reading exercise today we are going to do, and the topic of our reading exercise is Beauty and the Beast. So look at the picture. Who are these people? Just guessing. Okay, after reading you will understand that who are they. But here, by looking at the picture only, what do you think that? Who are these people? Yes, you are right. That they seem like they are the family, right? Father is there and daughters are there, right? And what about, what is the name of the animal in the second picture? Yes, it is a beast. Good. Now, what does the mane do? See, the mane is standing in front of the beast. Then what do you think that? What does the man do? Get scared and run away, or have conversation, or make some request? Okay, we will read the story and then find out what is exactly the man will do. Now, I want you and me, both of us, we will read the story together, and while reading, you will underline the unfamiliar words. If you find underline, if every words are familiar for you, then it's okay. Did you get what you are going to do now? Yes, reading together with me and underlining the unfamiliar words there. You can also see there some making requests, some sentences, and then responding them. That also you can see, okay? But your task now is to underline the unfamiliar words. Okay, so let's begin. Let's start reading the story, Beauty and the Beast. Once upon a time, there lived a merchant with his three daughters at the edge of a dense forest. One day, as he was about to leave home for a walk in the town, he asked all three daughters if they wanted any presents on his return. The eldest daughter was excited and said, "Oh yes, will you bring me dresses made of silk?" "Very well, those are expensive. I will try," replied the merchant. The second daughter also had a similar demand. She said, "Oh father, could you please bring me pearl earrings?" The merchant then asked his youngest daughter, Beauty, who was the most beautiful and thoughtful of them all. She said, "You may just bring me some roses, father." The merchant was pleased by the simple demand of Beauty. Promising to try his best to bring them all what they had asked for, he left for the town. On his way back to the village, through the dark and dense forest, he lost his way. He suddenly reached the gates of an old and ruined castle. As he passed through the gate inside, he saw a huge bush full of white roses. He happily decided to pluck a few for his Beauty. Just when he was about to pluck the first rose, he heard a roar behind him. "How dare you walk inside my castle without my permission?" The merchant was very scared when he saw a dangerous beast with the head of a lion, the body of a bear, and the legs of a wild dog standing in front of him. "I'm sorry. I saw these roses and wanted to take for my Beauty," he said, terrified. "You thief! I won't let you get away with this," snarled the beast. "Sorry, please let me go back to my daughters. I don't want the flowers," the merchant replied, shivering with fear. The beast spoke after a while. "Go home, but send your daughter who wanted the roses. Don't lie. If you don't send your daughter by tomorrow evening, I will come to take you all," he shouted. Reaching home that night, he told what had happened in the forest to his daughters. Although Beauty's sister told the merchant to send Beauty to the beast so that they would be safe, the loving father did not agree. However, Beauty decided to go to the beast to save her family. The following night, she left home without telling anyone. As Beauty reached the castle of the beast, it warmly welcomed her and took her inside. She was given a proper room to live and well-cooked food to eat. The beast treated her well as a friend. After living there for a few months, Beauty and the beast became best friends and lived together. Beauty missed her father and sisters as well. So one night, she asked the beast to give her a day to go to meet her father and sisters. the beast agreed to let her go back for only a day. After she returned home, all became happy to see her back, so they lived happily for weeks. Slowly, Beauty forgot that the beast was waiting for her in the castle. One night, she had a dream that the beast was very sick and he was calling her name. Worried that the beast was really sick and guilty and she had broken his trust, she ran back to the castle the next day. Reaching the castle, she found out that the beast was really ill. "Oh, I'm so sorry I left you alone," she said to him with tears in her eyes. "I'm so happy to see you after all these days, Beauty." "I feared you would never come back," said the beast. After that, Beauty started crying and her tears fell upon the beast's face. Magically, the beast turned into a handsome young man. "Who you are?" Beauty was surprised. "It's me, the beast," the young man said. He spoke again. "I was a prince. I used to kill the wild animals a lot. So the god had given me a punishment and turned me into a beast. When I pleaded the god to turn me back to a human, the god said that only a true friend's teardrops would help. Now you help me turn into a human." Beauty was overjoyed to hear this. Later, they invited Beauty's father and sisters to live with them in the castle. They all came to live happily together forever. Okay, so did you enjoy this story? Did you like it? Of course, yes. I hope that you have underlined the unfamiliar words. Okay, can you see that some of the differences in my sentences, where some words are in different color? Why I have done so? Yes, your guessing is correct. Some these words may be unfamiliar for you. I thought so, and then I had highlighted them. The words which you have underlined and these are same or different? Yes, they are same. Okay, that's good. Now, then I'm going to show you some words here. Okay, so you have to guess the meaning of these words. Okay, so let me keep this here. The word from the story, this one, snarled, terrified, ruined. Did you see these words? I want you to see there whether the word you have underlined these or not. Okay. This expensive. Okay. Then the next one word is scared. No, wait, pleaded. Okay. Pleaded is another word. And the next one is shivering. Okay. These are the words I have written here from this story. Okay. So now I'm going to show you the meaning. Now you have to match them. Okay, whether they are similar in the meaning or not, you have to match them. Just look at, I'll give you time, don't worry. Okay, so how many words are here? Yes, you're right, there are 12 words. Okay, so now let me read the words first. snarled. What is this? Snarled. Terrified. Ruined. Expensive. Pleaded. Shivering. Okay, so these are the words. Now you have to guess that. What may be the meaning? Okay. Shaking, growled angrily, requested, costly, damaged, and scared. These are the words. These are the meaning. Okay. Synonyms you can just say. So snarled means what? Just guess. Shaking, growled angrily, requested, costly, damaged, scared. Which one is? Yes, you're right. Snarled means growled angrily. Okay, let me do this like this. Snarled means growled angrily. Who growled angrily? Yes, you're right. Beast growled angrily. When he growled angrily, when he saw that the merchant was plucking the roses, okay, coming inside his castle, right? So he growled angrily. Terrified. What does terrified means? Yes. With a shaking, requested, costly, damaged, scared. Which one maybe? Yes, you're right. Terrified means scared. Okay? See here. Terrified is scared. Ruined. Ruined is shaking, or requested, or costly, or damaged. What do you think? The castle was ruined. Okay, yes, you are right. Damaged. Okay, some of the parts of the castle was damaged. So, ruined is damaged. Expensive. The girls, you know, first and second daughters, they wanted some expensive gift. Right? So, shaking, requested, or costly? Which one? Good. This is costly. Expensive means costly. Pleaded. Okay. Who pleaded in this story? Yes, you are right. The merchant pleaded. With whom? Yes, in front of the beast. Okay. With beast, he pleaded. So, pleaded is shaking or requested? What is that? Good, you're right. Requested. Okay, pleaded is requested. Now, the last one, of course it is, shivering is shaking. Who was shivering there? The merchant was shivering. Why? Because he saw beast getting angry. Right. So, these are some of the unfamiliar words and their meaning. Okay, thank you so much. Now, let's move ahead. You can see there in your textbook two different columns, words and the meaning. Now, you have to match the words in column A with the meanings in column B. Okay, so I give you 5 minutes. Okay, within that time frame, you have to complete this. Can you do this? Mm-hmm. Okay, so what are you going to do? Yes, you are going to match the words in column A with their meanings in column B. Okay, take your time. Thank you so much. So now, just tell me the answer. Dense, castle, scared, roar, and punishment. These are the words from the textbook. And the meaning of the words are given here. Bad treatment, thick, make a loud noise as of an animal, to make a person or animal feel frightened, a large building where the king or other great person resides. You can see here, a large building, right? So, dense means what? Which one is correct here? Yes, you are right. Dense is thick. Okay. Castle, you are right. A large building where the king or other great person resides. Resides means lives. Scared, to make a person or animal feel frightened. What about roar? Good. Make a loud noise as of an animal. And the punishment means? Good. Punishment means bad treatment. Okay, so these are the words from the textbook and then their meaning. So I hope that including these words and then these words, now everything is clear for you. There is no any unfamiliar word left. So till now, whatever we have done, we have read this story, we have discussed the meaning of the words, right? Okay, and maybe you have enjoyed reading this story together with me, yeah? Can you say that? How many characters are there in this story? Three daughters, merchant, and beast. How many characters? Yes, there are five characters, okay? And who was most beautiful among these three? Yes, the third one, the little one, Beauty was the beautiful one. Two daughters, what they demanded? Can you remember? One dress and then one pearl earring. Good. Now, let's go ahead. Next exercise. Read the text again and write true or false. So, when you have to do like this type of exercise, you have to go through the text in this way. Just have a look here. The youngest daughter's name was Beauty. Whether this is right, true or false. Okay, so just have a look here. The eldest daughter was excited and said, "Oh yes, will you bring me dresses made of silk?" Mm-hmm. "Very well, those are expensive. I will try," replied the merchant. The second daughter also had a similar demand. She said, "Oh, father, could you please bring me pearl earring?" Do you know pearl earring? Look at here, these are, okay, pearl earrings. The merchant then asked his youngest daughter, Beauty. So, what is the name of the youngest daughter? Correct, Beauty. Who was the most beautiful and thoughtful of them all. So, what will be the answer here? The youngest daughter's name was Beauty. True or false? Correct, it is true. Right, so the second daughter asked her father to bring her a dress made of silk. So, once again, look at there. The second daughter, you can see here, the eldest one, the second daughter. The second daughter also had a similar demand. She said, "Oh, father, could you please bring me pearl earring?" So, what do you think? The second daughter asked her father to bring her a dresses made of silk. Is it true or false? It is false. What is the true statement then? Yes, you're right. The second daughter asked her father to bring her pearl earrings. Right? Okay. You're very smart. Now, I'll give you 3 minutes. 3 questions remain here. You have to find in the same way. Go through the text, the story, and then after find out whether these remaining three sentences are true or false. Okay? What are you going to do? Finding the sentences there in the story and decide whether the sentences are true or false. Okay. Thank you so much. The merchant reached the castle of Beast in the forest. Is this true or false? Correct. You're right. It is true statement. He lost in the middle of the jungle and then he reached to the castle of Beast. The Beast turned into a beautiful young lady. Is it correct? No. Yes, you are right. This is false statement. What is the true statement then? The Beast turned into a beautiful young boy. Okay, gentleman can say. Beauty and the young prince lived happily with their family. True or false? Yes, finally, happy ending. We can see that in the story that Beauty and young prince lived happily with their family. This is true. Now, let's move ahead to the next exercise. Put the following sentences in correct order. Okay, now the sentences here, these are the summary, like summary of the whole story. Now you have to keep them in order. You know, what happened in the beginning, then after what event happened, after that what event happened. Based on the event, you have to write them. How the story presented there, you have to write accordingly to these words. So the merchant raced to a dangerous beast in the castle. The beast turned into a handsome young prince. Beauty went to the beast to save her other family members. Beauty and the prince lived happily thereafter. The merchant was about to go to a town. Three daughters demanded to bring different things. The merchant reached home with a sad story. So these are the sentences. Now, which came first? Look at here in this story. Once upon a time, there lived a merchant with his three daughters at the edge of a dense forest. One day, as he was about to leave home for a walk in the town, he asked all three daughters if they wanted any present on his return. So, which sentence here is first then? Yes, you're right. Number E. The merchant was about to go to a town. Okay, the beginning of this story is this. The merchant was about to go to the town. Now, after this, what happened? He asked that all three daughters if they wanted any present on his return. Then after they had demanded different things, right? So which one is the second one then? Yes, you are right. Number F. Three daughters demanded to bring different things. Okay, so in this way, there are other five sentences. You have to find what order they are in. Okay, you read the story and then look at the sentence and match that, which is in order, in right order. Okay, I'll give you 5 minutes for this. Within that time, please do it. Thank you so much. Okay, so what have you written there? Now, number third is, which one is number third? Number C. Good, you're right. The merchant raced to a dangerous beast in the castle. When he was returning back from the town, he raced to a dangerous beast in the castle. Then after what? Yes, the merchant raced home with a sad story. Why he was sad? Actually, he was raised to a dangerous beast in the castle, and then the beast told to send the youngest daughter who demanded roses, right? So he was very sad, right? He has a very sad story of meeting with the beast. Then after, good, Beauty went to the beast to save her other family members. Did Beauty tell these things to her family? No. Without telling anyone, at night, she left her house. Why? She wanted to save her family members. And second last one. Good. The beast turned into a handsome young prince. And finally, Beauty and the prince lived happily thereafter. Okay, so in this way, you can write the sentences in order. You have to look at the story or the text given there, and in which order they are presented there. Accordingly, you have to write the sentences. In that way, we can put the sentences in correct order. Do you have any questions up to now? We have done match the word with the meaning. We have also done true, false, right? And we have done this, put the following sentences in correct order. Now we are at the last of the exercise of today. Answer the following questions. Okay, there are some questions. You have to find answers. What did the eldest daughter ask her father to bring? Now, I want you underline the answers there in this story so that you can do the work quickly, right? You just turn to the page, okay? You go to the story, and then where is the answer of this question? Underline there. What did the eldest daughter ask her father to bring? Just have a look here. The eldest daughter was excited and said, "Oh yes, will you bring me dresses made of silk?" Okay, what is our demand? Yes, you wanted dresses made of silk. So what will you write then? The eldest daughter asked her father to bring dresses made of silk. Okay, can you write like this way? Okay, you can see the eldest daughter asked. I have written asked here. Why I have written asked? Why I have told you asked? Because the sentence here, you can see the verb used here is in past tense, right? So the eldest daughter did is here, so we will write in answer asked. The eldest daughter asked her father to bring dresses made of silk. In that way, you will write answer. Number B, what did Beauty ask her father to bring? So what was the Beauty's demand? Just look at here. The merchant then asked his youngest daughter, Beauty, who was the most beautiful and thoughtful of them all. Thoughtful means she was so considerable. She didn't demand anything which are very much expensive, right? She could understand the situation of her father. So she said, "You may just bring me some roses." Okay? What was her demand? To bring some roses, right? So what you will write there then? What did Beauty ask her father to bring? Beauty asked her father to bring some roses. Okay, can you repeat it? Good. Beauty asked her father to bring some roses. So in this way, find out other questions answer as well. It's so easy, you know, you can find answer very easily. You have to go through the reading text, and then you have to go through you don't have to read in detail everything because you have already read maybe twice, right? So now you can just look at where are the words and try to understand what is there and write in your own words. Don't copy exactly whatever it is written there in the story. Okay? So in this way, I hope you can do it nicely. Now, you have to retell this story in your own words. Okay, whatever this story was, the characters, the setting, okay, event, theme, everything we have read, you have understood, right? So today, while returning back home to your parents, you will tell the story of this Beauty and the Beast. Okay, can you tell this story? You can retell that in your own words. You should not follow it in everything from this story. You can write in your, you can say in your own way, but try to make it interesting, okay? So thank you so much, everyone. Thank you so much for being here and then listening to me. I hope you have enjoyed the lesson very well. So keep on reading, keep on trying. Thank you so much. We will discuss the questions in our next class. Thank you.